So in paribhasha prakarana, the second one is avap samskara. So avapana. Best example is vanga jarana vidhi. So avap here, the word meaning is addition. Addition. So even it is named as achadana. Addition. That is adding the herbal powders to a molten metal or a mineral is named as avapa. Clear? So once the metal or mineral, it liquefies immediately, some prescribed herbal powders are added to that molten metal is named as avapa or prativapa, or even it is named as achadana. Okay, so let me read the shloka. Shloka reference is Rasa Tarangini, 2nd chapter, 39th shloka. Dravyantara vinikshepo drute vangadike tu yaha. Kriyate sa prativapaha avapascha nigadhyate. So here meaning is Dravyantara vinikshepo drute vangadike. Some herbal drugs, the powder, porous powdered herbal drugs are added to molten metals are the minerals. For example, vangadike, vangar, it may be naga or it may be yashada. So here he has put an example of vanga and adike. Vanga and other such metals and minerals. Dravyantara vinikshepa drute vangadike tu yaha. Kriyate sa prativapaha avapascha nigantiti. So that process, adding the herbal powders into molten metal, is named as avapana kriya. Okay. So for the same concept, and the shloka from Rasaratna Samuchaya, drute dravyantarakshepo lohadehi kriyatehi yaha sa avapaha prativapaha tat eva achadanam matam. So here he has used the one more word, that is achadana. So in Rasaratna Samuchaya, which was written by Acharya Rasavagbhata, he has added one more word, that is achadana kriya. So why it is named as achadana means, once the powder is added to the molten metal, so it covers the molten metal. Okay, it make a layer on the surface of the molten metal or liquefied metal. So that's what the process is even named as achadana. It covers the molten metal, achadana kriya. Okay, so these are the two references available for avapana kriya. Okay, avapana is addition. So here you can quote the example of vanga jarana vidhi. So in vanga jarana vidhi, as shown in the picture, in the first picture, it is regarding the molten tin. Okay, that is vanga is heated in a loha darvi or in an iron pan or the loha kadai. Then once it melts, then ashwatha churna is added to that molten tin, and it is continuously stirred with the help of a spatula or a spoon till it attains the powder form. So once the powder mixes with the molten metal, immediately it is covered with the help of an earthen saucer. So later on we'll get the fine powder of vanga or the tin, so as shown in the second picture. So this is the best example for avapa kriya. Okay, so the different synonyms which are quoted for avapa are, so that is avapa, prativapa, achadana. Clear? So here you remember the best example is vanga jarana vidhi. Next one is nirvapa. See, be clear with the words. Dalana is pouring, avapa is addition of the powdered drugs into molten metal. Third one is nirvapana kriya. So nirvapana means you can consider it as a immersion. Okay, or heating and dipping. Heating and dipping. Okay, best example is the first maharasa, that is abraka. So in abraka shodhana, we are following nirvapana samskara. That is immersion or heating and dipping. So here the process is, the metal or mineral is subjected to heat. Okay, it is heated on the gas stove till it become red hot. So once the material become red hot, immediately it is dipped into a specific liquid media. It may be herbal juice, or it may be decoction, or it may be milk, or it may be cow's urine. Okay, so that is the process of nirvana. So it is repeated for 5 to 7 times. Okay, so even nirvapana is named as nishekchana vidhi or snapana vidhi. Nishekchana or snapana vidhi. Okay, so clear. Nirvapa is eating and dipping. So let me read the shloka. Shloka reference is Rasatarangini, 2nd chapter, 40th shloka. Dhatvade vanhitaptasya jaladau yat nishekchanam sa nirvapaha smritaha cha apihi nishekaha snapanam cha tat. Okay, so the meaning is dhatvadehi, dhatu and adi, dhatvadehi. Dhatu means metal and other rasadravyas, minerals. Okay, any metal or mineral, dhatvadehi, vanhitaptasya. So the dhatu, metal or mineral, is heated on the gas stove. One hit up the sea till it become red hot. Jalado, jala and adi. So jala is water. Ado, ado means, so it may be herbal juice, that is swarasa, or it may be kwata, decoction, or it may be milk, godugda, or it may be gomutra, cow's urine. Okay, so that's what he has used the word jala ado. Okay, jala and etc. Dhatva dehi, one hit up the sea, jalado, yet nishechana. Sa nirvapaha, the process of heating and dipping into specified liquid media is named as nirvapa. Sa nirvapaha smritaha cha apihi nishekaha snapanam cha tat. So this nirvapana kriya is even named as nisheka or snapana kriya. Okay, so the one more reference for nirvapa according to Rasaratna Samuchaya, 8th chapter, 54th shloka. Taptasya apsu vinikshepo nirvapaha snapanam cha tataha. Clear? So meaning is taptasya apsu. Apsu is jal or any liquid medium. Clear? Taptasya, the red hot material. It may be metal or mineral. Taptasya apsu vinikshepo. The heated, the red hot material is dropped into any liquid media. Taptasya apsu vinikshepo nirvapaha snapanam cha tataha. Okay, so it's regarding the nirvapana samskara. So here the synonyms are nisheka and snapana, and the example, so the best example is abraka shodhana vidhi or samanya shodhanas of dhatus. Okay, so as shown in the picture, so it's regarding the abraka shodhana vidhi. The mica is heated on the gas stove till it become red hot, then it is dipped in liquid media, the specific liquid media for the purification of abraka shodhana. So generally trifla kwata is used, gomutra is used, kanji is used, or godugda is used. Okay, prataptam saptavarani nikshipte kanjike abrakam as the reference shloka. Okay, so for nirvapa you can quote the best example is abraka shodhana vidhi.